thing is, now I want to show you the same thing in the New Testament. What God is saying is, hey, in the olden days, in the people, I choose only one race, Israel. But in the New Testament days, God sent His Son into the world and He selected a whole world for Him. Whoever believes in me, they will be redeemed. Amen. Hallelujah. Whoever comes into me. So now I want to see the high priest of the Old Testament, and I wanted to show you the high priest of the New Testament. And this high priest of the New Testament, by name, Jesus. And Jesus is anointed by God and sent by God. And Jesus is our redeemer. Jesus is our reconciliation. Jesus is our forgiver. So whatever in the Old Testament, oh God help us, whatever in the Old Testament, in the New Testament, God has fulfilled through Jesus to be the high priest, not just through the blood and the, you know, blood of the bulls and the goat, but the very blood of Jesus, so that Jesus himself can take the blood and enter into the Holy of Holies once for all, that he can bring the salvation to the whole humanity. Oh, glory to God. But there is no church age. You got to understand Bible so clearly, then only you can know that. Now I'm talking only in the Old Testament, and I'm talking only showing in the New Testament, and the Old Testament is the high priest Aaron, in the New Testament the high priest is Jesus. But after Jesus, what he did is, like Aaron, though he's not, oh God help us this morning, is not holy, God has declared him holy, because the purpose of God is whoever stands in the high priest position, unless they are not holy, they cannot shed the blood of their own. So that's the reason God prepared Jesus in a human form without sin and defilement, so that Jesus is the only person who is called as a holy. Hallelujah. To show who is a holy, he's showing the foresight of our Old Testament. Hey, priest got to be holy. Though he's not holy, I declare him holy, that next I send my son, he will be the holy man. Glory be to God. He blew my mind last night. There's a reason I'm saying this. There's a reason I'm saying I didn't come to the third church age. Listen carefully. Hebrew 9:24. I want to read these passages so that you understand. My desire is that you should understand the word of God this morning. Then only the blessing will be received. Amen. Hallelujah. And the Bible tells me, for Christ did not enter a sanctuary made with human hands, because the tabernacle was made with human hands. That's called the sanctuary. Old Testament, the tabernacle is called the sanctuary. Sanctuary means the dwelling place of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Sanctuary means the dwelling place of God. And the Bible says in Hebrew 9:24, for Christ did not enter a sanctuary made with human hands that was only copy of the one, but he entered heaven, the sanctuary itself, now to appear in God's presence. Every time Aaron is appearing in the Holy of Holies in the God's presence, but God, who has a tabernacle, a sanctuary not made by the hand, Jesus went and stood there. And what he did in Hebrews 7:24-25, but because Jesus lives forever, he has a permanent priesthood. Amen. Hallelujah. The Old Testament, the priest will be changed. Amen. Hallelujah. It's a temporary priesthood. But in the New Testament, God made it a permanent priesthood. Amen. Hallelujah. As so in the churches. I'll come to the churches. Alright? And then says that one who is holy, innocent, undefiled, separated from sinners, and exalted above the heavens. In other words, Jesus, the priestly position should be a holy position. But in the Old Testament is a shadow, and the New Testament is a section. Whatever God used, the shadow is fulfilled in the life of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. That's what it is. So God is fulfilling. I showed you as a model of the holiness, but I am the true model. Amen. Hallelujah. And the reality which no sin for me, no defilement for me. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, in the Old Testament, it is the sacrifice of the bulls and the goats. But now I read it in Hebrew chapter 9, 11 to 14. He did not enter by means of the blood of the goats or calves, but he entered the most holy place once for all by his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. And this redemption is not for the Jews alone. This redemption is for the whole world. If Jews comes into that, they take it. If Jews doesn't come into that, they don't take it. But Christian is not a Jew. Christian is born in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Holy be. People of God, in verse 14, Hebrew chapter 9, verse 14 says, how much more than the blood of Christ, who brought the eternal spirit, offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our conscience from everything, from the dead. So, Old Testament is a shadow, and New Testament is a substance. Listen carefully. I'm very clearly using my words. You're going to have Old Testament is always projected who Jesus is going to be. Amen? Hallelujah. So when Jesus is coming, he fulfilled the Old Testament. He did not discard the Old Testament. He said, I come to fulfill the law. Law is the Old Testament. So God never avoided the law. God has fulfilled the law in Jesus, and he brought us into another stage called the church, which is not abide by the law, which is abide by the grace of God. Hallelujah. So we are translated from the law to the grace through Jesus, who is our kinsman and the redeemer, and thereby we can completely depend on not the blood of the bulls of the cow. We depend on the very shed blood of Jesus. Thereby I be holy. Glory be to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Now I come to the church age.